Aloha, good morning, good afternoon, and good evening. My name is Master Paul, and it is my pleasure to be connecting with you here today. It is a Monday, it is February 12th, and we are coming up on Valentine's Day. I hadn't considered it, but I guess maybe tomorrow I will do a Valentine's Day special presentation. So I guess that makes today the 13th, since tomorrow is the 14th. So it's good to see all of you. Thank you so much for tuning in and coming to this live stream. I am a master teacher and student of Dr. Master Jigong Sha, and a great deal of what I share with you is based on the wisdom and teachings from the books of Dr. and Master Sha. And so I'm grateful for today's subject, which will be on ego and the opposite of that, which is humility. And their associations with our self-worth and self-esteem, whether we have a high level of it or insufficient amount of it. So it will be very valuable and beneficial in many, many ways to receive this information. Now for me, I will be receiving some sacred wisdom on this to offer whatever guidance and assistance can assist us both. For the longest time, I have to say, I only understood the word ego as a certain category, so to speak. You know, the obvious, you know, when somebody is showing off, that kind of thing. But in the spiritual wisdom and teachings of Master Sha, I've come to understand a much greater arena in which the ego shows up. Master Sha has been teaching about what is called the 10 Das, and Da stands for greatest. It's a Mandarin Chinese word. So the 10 Das are the 10 greatest virtues, the 10 greatest ways of being in life. And you've heard me mention them before, but for those that are new, I'll re-mention them. There is Da Ai, the greatest love. Da Quan Chu, the greatest forgiveness. Da Si Bei, the greatest compassion. Da Guangming, the greatest light. Da Qianbei, which is the greatest humility, the subject of today. There is Da He She, the greatest harmony. Then there is Da Gan Un, greatest flourishing. The eighth of the Tadas is Da Gan In, the greatest gratitude. The ninth is Da Fu Wu, greatest service. And the tenth of the Ten Das is Da Yuan Man, which means greatest enlightenment. And so, having come back from a very expansive and empowering retreat with Master Sha, a great deal of the focus was on purification of these 10 Das, these 10 great and important virtues, to bring them into our life so much more than they currently are. And so last week I focused on Da Ai, the greatest love, and we used Da Ai to apply it on the first day. We applied it to clear blockages with self-love. Then we applied it, Da'ai, the greatest love, to clear blockages in a chosen specific relationship. On the third day, we used Da'ai to bring blessings and transformation to our relationships. And then on the fourth day, we used Da'ai for a health concern, health issue. And I used the Da'ai calligraphy for that blessing. So for those that were here, of course, they know the value of those 4 days. That those that were not, I encourage you to come to my Facebook page and scroll down through them and watch any of those, because they remain on my page. There's also above this video is information how to access the archives. Excuse me. Hopefully this won't be too much today. So I want to acknowledge everybody that's joined in today so far. And then we'll move forward with today's wisdom, teaching, and blessing. So welcome, Petra. Welcome, Ilona. Welcome, Tammy Hunter. Aloha, Kristen Strachan. Welcome, Chris Lewis. Welcome, Dana. Aloha, Nirma. Welcome, CJ. And Angie. Good to see you, Angie. Welcome, Kristen Rojas. Aloha, Pat. Hi, Linda. And then well, thank you, Ilona, for your comments. Aloha, Master Anne. Aloha, Avalan. And Yvonne, good to see you here, Yvonne. Welcome, Zilke. Aloha, Carol and Johnny. Long time no here. Good to see you here, Johnny. Welcome, Meg. And welcome, Stephanie. And anybody else I have not mentioned. And thank you, by the way, for clicking on that share button and letting other people know about this live stream today. So as we spoke about the subject of humility, the subject of the ego, it has many, many faces. As we know, ego has a face. But there are quite a few ranges in which ego shows up in our life. And very often it's unexpected. It can be in defensive postures. Ego can show up in the form of being the victim. There are many, many ways that ego can show up. It shows up in the weak as well as the strong. And it has a unique way of expressing itself. The purpose of ego, in almost every case, is defensiveness. So how is it that it can show up for somebody that has, for example, low self-esteem? It is a defensive posture that allows that person to remain in a place of weakness. It is a posture that is adopted. And when I say posture, I don't mean a physical posture. I mean a way of being. It is a way of being that is adopted that allows them to maintain something that brings them a return, I guess is a good way to put it. Because why would... Excuse me. Drink some water here, see if that makes a difference for me. Why would a person stay in a physically abusive relationship year after year after year when people have given them chances to leave, when people have given them very sage and good advice, and yet they still remain? The answer is there is a payoff of some level. And this is how ego works. It has to do with getting something in return. Now, I don't know what that person that stays in an abusive relationship might be getting, but maybe it's attention, maybe it's a form of love that you and I would not acknowledge as valuable. But regardless, there is a payoff. And that's what happens with ego and a lack of humility. There is always something for the reason why people do what they do that others might look at and say, you know, I don't think that's the best choice. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and connect us all heart to heart, soul to soul. And we're going to chant love, peace, and harmony together. And then I will offer some sacred wisdom that I will receive to share with us at this time. And we'll see what additional information might come through. I want to welcome Anne-Marie Price. Welcome, Emily. Also welcome to Ben. And welcome, Monica. Thank you all for joining. And also thank you for sharing the video. So let us connect. We have what's called the Soul Light Era Soul Service Hand Position. Basically, it's a hand mudra that allows us to connect to the higher aspects of our beingness into our heart center. So we place our hands pointed towards heaven, our left hand in front of our heart center, right hand pointed towards heaven. We close our eyes. And we invite in all beings of light. We deeply love you, honor you, and appreciate you. We honor each belief system, each being that is serving the light. We ask that you be with us here today to bless our soul journey, to bless this communication today, to bless the words, the thoughts, and the actions to bring about the greatest value to each of those that are joining us. Dear the Source Soul Song of Love, Peace, and Harmony, transmitted to all souls in all universes, we love you, we honor you, deeply appreciate you. We ask that you join us here today at this time. And as we chant love, peace, and harmony, please chant with us. We ask that we offer this service unconditionally. So for those that are not familiar with this Source Soul Song, you may avail yourself of it by clicking on some of the links that Kristen has posted. Thank you, Kristen. And you just close your eyes and receive the blessing as we chant to set the energy field. Lula lulali, lula lulali, lula lulali, lula lulali, lula Lula, hallelujah. Wang ling rong her mu shir shang xiong ai ping an xie xiong ai ping an xie. I love my heart and soul. I love all humanity. Join hearts and souls together. Love, peace, and harmony. Love, peace, and harmony. Lula, lula, li. Lula, lula, la, li. Lula, lula, li, lula, lula, ha, li, lula, lula, ha, li, lula. Wo ai wo xin er ling, wo ai tran ren lei. Wang ling rong er mu shi sheng. Xiong ai ping an xie, xiong ai ping an xie. I love my heart and soul. I love all humanity. Join hearts and souls together. Love, peace, and harmony. Love, peace, and harmony. Ha, ha, ha. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Deeply apologize about clearing my throat a lot. I'm actually quite healthy. I'm just having some sinus drainage. So welcome, Dean. Welcome, Elizabeth. Welcome, Dove. And welcome, Sarianne. Thank you all very much for joining today. So I'm going to start by offering some sacred wisdom. I'm going to tune in and connect to this wisdom and then share. You can let me know if it resonates with you or not. Okay? The idea that the ego can reside in someone with low self-esteem is the antithesis of what makes sense to the ego, to the mind. It has been seen through television and real life that the ego is most recognized and most predominant in those that are outspoken, those that have something to lose, those that wish to be seen and heard. It is, in most cases, clearly understood that there is an overcompensation that is occurring for these individuals that are communicating with such zest and zeal, such outlandishness, so to speak. This is the obvious version of ego. Da Qian Bei is the Mandarin Chinese word that means the greatest humility. So in order to understand how ego, the opposite of humility, can have many faces, including the face of those who are, shall we say, low in self-esteem, one must first understand what is humility. The greatest humility is one who has no attachment. They do not care to be seen, liked, appreciated, understood, or validated. They have no need for any external acceptance, appreciation, or validation. The greatest humility is one who would clean the feet of the vagrant as well as the Pope, with no hesitation, with no judgment or criticism. The greatest humility is one who sees themselves as equal to, not greater, not lesser. But if there is one that sees themselves as greater to the one who has no humility, the one with no humility simply honors them the same way. They would give them the shirt off their back the same way as they would give the vagrant the shirt off their back. The one with no ego is clearly one who has no ulterior motive. Ulterior motive is developed. It is brought about through the way life has created the personality of the individual through their upbringing and years. The parenting, the belief systems, the teacher or teachings, the way the siblings communicate, as well as the friends and what is called enemies. All of these facilitate activity in the mind of the individual, and the individual originates from a place of purity and love. So after entrance into this realm, this individual goes through a bit of molding, if you will. Their reactions, their positioning of their way they think, the way they respond or react, is directly related to how they absorbed and categorized their early life experiences. It is fair to say that out of the 7 billion souls that have entered this realm, that they all have aspects of ego, with very, very, very few exceptions. Those who have done well to identify the different ways it shows up are further along the path to enlightenment than those that have not. So now that you understand what is humility, I will offer sacred wisdom as to how the ego can show up in the various types of personalities and people. For the one that is in a place of significant emotional trauma, let us say depression, etc. Just an example. This soul has had experiences that has caused them to hold things down. Not every case, but in this example, the ego caused them to not reply, caused them to not do something about what created the condition that they hid or held back, the condition that brought about a series of emotions before depression set in. So as you can see in this example, ego was about being right, being afraid, not standing up for self. This is something where there is a need for honoring of self. Honoring of self is the same as saying, I am not a doormat. I do not judge thy actions, but I honor thyself. There is a unique balance in this example. There are other examples where, using the example of a love, where there is two people who come together, and one of the people makes an action that would be called inappropriate, possibly outside of the boundaries of accepted matrimony, etc. And so the other, how do they react? How do they respond? Did they respond with love, but balance it with honoring of self? Or did they hide it and create drama? These are aspects of ego, protection of self. It can be said that ego is protection of self. It can be said that humility is honoring of self. One causes a choice in love, a choice that sustains the betterment of the individual, and one is a choice in safety, in defense, in hiding, so to speak. These are but some examples to work with in your greater understanding of the different ways in which humility can be improved. Humility can be seen. So the next time you find yourself in a place where you hide a bit, shudder a bit, deflate your own value and worth a bit, recognize the payoff. Recognize that you are not honoring yourself, that you are not being in love with yourself in this manner, and choose instead to stop this pattern, which is not serving you, and to move forward with a greater love, both exteriorly and, of course, towards self. So this is an example of some sacred wisdom that we have received through Dr. and Master Sha, that we have received through the Ten Da wisdom and teachings. When we can recognize the different places that ego shows up in ourselves, everybody that's watching this today is on a spiritual journey. They are on their own path, and it may include this and this wisdom and the Ten Das, and it may be everything to you. And it may be that this is the last time you hear or see this wisdom, and you're off on a different path entirely somewhere else. But regardless of where your path takes you, it's very, very important to recognize that we are all in the same ship on the way back to enlightenment. We are all inside the same vessel of our original creator. And we are never separate, obviously, from our original creator, nor are we separate from each other. So the sacred wisdom shared that it is very important to honor ourself and love the other. Very often we make choices, reactions, or internal responses where we make a defensive response, we hide inside and be angry inside, We gossip to others, but we won't say anything to that individual. And if it hasn't worked, where you've tried to say something to that individual and it didn't work out for you, then there are other choices that are honoring of you. And at the same time, you work with love and forgiveness to move through and past the potential spiritual imbalances that are occurring with that particular relationship, using this as an example. So in working with the greatest humility, we want to take a look at how we ourselves can be more in alignment with our soul's calling, and its necessity to be free of judgment, criticism, and other factors such as self-aggrandization, wherein we allow ourselves to be put down, either by our own self-judgments or those outside of us. What is tends to be very common in my own personal observation is those that have significant low self-esteem, a lack of love of self, very often it has to do with a lack of gratitude and a lack of love for self. They will put themselves down. They will look in the mirror and say unpleasant things about their eyes, their wrinkles, their face, their hair, their you know, muscles, whatever it might be. This is obviously not loving self. And you know, many of the sacred wisdom and teachings out there speak about love thyself. There is many of the clients in my Soulmate Attraction System program that when we whittle away at the things that separate us from having that love, in a good chunk of the cases, there is separation from love of self. And so when we look at the subject today of humility, a big part of that is recognizing where we deny ourselves, where we don't allow ourselves to be honored. Okay. Also, one of the things that came through in the sacred wisdom surrounding humility is when we don't give love to others, we instead blame or judge them, we criticize them. As with all of the teachings that Master Sha has brought to us, there is a lot of sharing and wisdom around the nature of forgiveness and, of course, love. And so no one's saying it's okay to be at the end of a person who is unpleasant towards us, battering towards us, etc., etc. But what is relevant in the honoring process is honoring that's where that soul is at. And we are where we are at. So we're going to honor ourselves and we're going to release them with love and forgiveness and then move about our own soul journey and not be hampered by that anymore. This is walking forward in a place of love and humility. So it's very important to strive for that as the pattern. Many of us, when we reach 30, 40, 50 years old, we have had one or more relationships that are significant in our life. And typically one or more of those have brought a significant amount of pain. And one of the reasons why that pain occurs is because we have accepted false teachings in that we have accepted that love is supposed to come from outside of us. When we have love for ourself, when we acknowledge and accept positive comments or comments of gratitude towards us, we are in essence loving ourselves. We are in essence moving into a place of honoring of self. Humility is not saying, oh, no, that's not true. No, I'm sorry. That's not humility. That's denial. That is not allowing yourself to be honored. It's not loving yourself. This is an aspect of ego. I had to be taught that. I was one of those people that was, oh, no, it's okay. I didn't really do anything. But inside, I was like, oh, that's a good response, you know? That was a very, you know, good response. No. So where? Why does that come from? The need to be liked, the need to be appreciated, the need to be seen as a little better than, It's the ego. These are all various aspects of ego. So they show up in many different facets, and that's just another one of them. Now, as I think back to some of the sacred wisdom teachings, give me a moment to recollect. Well, it'll come back to me in a second. But I wanted to go back to when we are in a relationship, so to speak. Part of a big aspect of why that occurs is because we are trying to fill the other half of our heart with somebody else. And it's very important to recognize that that will never work. It never has, never will. When we came from our source creator, whatever name you wish to give that, there's many, many different names out there for different beliefs. But whatever the source creator is, when we came from there, it is my understanding that we were whole and complete. And we came here as to have additional experience. Had we stayed connected, had we had parenting, teaching, and a very pure set of teachings growing up, it's very likely we would have all been fulfilling our heart from that same source. But in almost every case, for almost every human being on this planet, we didn't get this kind of wisdom and teachings. Therefore, we found ourselves separated from source. And we found it started looking for love outside of our source. We started looking for love in other people. Now, it's not that that's not a value. It's actually of great value. It can bring us to some exceptional places. However, when we put the onus on somebody else to accomplish our love for us, we set ourselves up for failure. And so when I look at this subject of where we can be more humble, where we can have more humility, one of them is in the recognition of our source creator. We don't give near enough credit to our source. Now, maybe you're the exception to the rule. Maybe you walk through every moment in that place. I don't, and I could say I probably, if I collected all the moments in the course of a day, it might add up to a half hour where I'm totally in a place of sincere gratitude to my beloved creator. So if we took the time to fully recognize the amazing, amazing synchronicity of everything that happens in our life, everything that comes to us, if it's seen with gratitude, regardless of the label of being good or bad, if we see every person that enters and exits our life as being in divine timing, we could find ourselves in a much better place. As was stated earlier, now it's coming back to me, the person who is living and walking through humility, they have no judgment, they have no criticism. If somebody spits on them, they don't take it personally. They recognize that that's where that person's at on their soul journey, and they simply honor them with love and walk the other direction, how one of our spiritual fathers, Jesus, has done. And this is an exact example of greatest humility. So we must model some of those activities that we've seen before us. And one of the ways to accomplish that is align ourselves to the heart of our Creator. That can be done so many different ways. How many of you literally, literally have stopped and looked at any form of a flower anywhere on this day, or even yesterday for that matter? I can guarantee you walked by one somewhere, a live flower somewhere. You'd have to be living in an iced place. And even if you lived in an icy place, it's reasonable and possible that somewhere at work or at home there was a flower somewhere. And so did you actually stop and look at the amazing velvety of it? Did you say, my goodness, Creator, how amazing is this creation that you've made? When was the last time you did that for a painting or anything outside of you? When we start to acknowledge the divine in everything, what are we actually doing? We are reconnecting to our original source. We are reconnecting to the parts of us that caused us, by being separate of it, that caused us to create ego, caused us to create a way of bringing ourselves to life. ego is the way we bring ourselves to life. It is our patterns, it is our reactions, it is our lack of reactions. Ego is our responses. Ego is our lack of response. Ego is the way we bring ourselves to life, and it is built upon the way we have created ourselves from our parenting, our upbringing, etc., etc. And if any part of your life is not running perfectly, then we want to look at what is that source of it. We are separate from creation. We are separate from original creator. How do we find our way back there? Acknowledging original creator. That's how we find our way back. Acknowledging in everything. Acknowledging it in our breath. Acknowledging when you look outside and you see the clouds form a beautiful shape. Or even if they just do, just stay in the blah form. Just the fact that there's a cloud is astounding. Okay? The color blue of the sky. Whatever it might be, there's everywhere. If you live in a snow belt right now, I'm blessed to be in Hawaii, but if you're in the snow belt, the snowflake itself. When I was in Orillia about a few weeks ago in Toronto, Canada, I stopped and marveled at the crystals on the window from a freeze. It was just gorgeous. There, I stopped and marveled at the little icicles coming off of the side of a building. And I was taking photos from different angles. I put my camera right up on the icicle, which gives this whole unique view through the icicle itself. This is being at one with the moment. In these cases, I was specifically saying, thank you, Divine. Thank you for this incredible beauty. So it's all around us. Each time we do that, what are we doing? We're eating the nectar of the divine life. We're eating the nectar of our original creator. We are fulfilling our heart. We are clearing our ego blockages. Every time we fill our heart with anything that is from creator, which by the way is all human beings, they're all from creator. The ones we love, the ones we don't love so much, they're still all from creator. And so as we move through life with love and forgiveness and see the great beauty that Creator has brought to us as much as possible, as much as we possibly can in each moment, then what in essence are we doing? In essence, we're filling our heart again. We're realigning ourselves to our original source. We are slowly but surely shoveling out the ego, slowly but surely shoveling out the thoughts, the words, the actions, the mindsets, the attitudes, and the beliefs. The ego, and of course the attachments that we have held on to as protectionistic mechanisms that we have developed throughout the course of our life. So it's very important to recognize that. I, for the longest time, have had a sarcasm about my way of communicating. In the last 10 or so years, I've curbed it substantially. Now, I will use it occasionally with those that are closest to me, knowing that it's an endearing thing. But for the most part, I have removed it from my vocabulary. Sarcasm is a way of separating ourselves from another, putting ourselves above another. There are so many different subtle ways that we have these defensive mechanisms, these posturings, these ways of bringing ourselves to the society around us so that we're accepted, so that we're loved, so that we're approved. The list goes on. And they show up deeper and deeper and deeper the more we awaken it to us. So this is a part and parcel of the wisdom and teachings of the deeper understandings of greatest humility, Da Chen Bei. So Da Chen Bei, the Mandarin Chinese word which means greatest humility, is one of the 10 virtues that Master Sha has brought to us. And I'll be focusing on it this week. Today, we're focusing on it specifically for communication with self. Tomorrow, I'm going to be using the greatest humility for focusing on relationship. And I'm going to ask you tomorrow when you return to choose a specific relationship. And we're going to take a close look at all the different places where we have chosen incorrectly, where we have chosen ego-based responses, where we could have used more humility and it could have created greater results. Okay? Today, we're focusing on ourself and how we could do better for ourself. I'm going to do a practice now. I'm going to use the mantra of Da Chen Bei. We're going to ask the calligraphy because there is a Da Chen Bei calligraphy. And I'm not prepared. I don't have it with me unless I have it on my... No, I took it out. So I don't have it with me to show you at this moment. But this very special calligraphy, my teacher, Master Sha, created. And it has significant blessings that have been invoked into it. And I will ask those to come to us to help us clear our blockages. Now, one thing I want everyone to be aware of is there are three ways to clear blockages. We can, of course, do love and forgiveness practices, and they are both sides of one coin, so I put them together. Love and forgiveness, self-love, and forgiveness of self for ego, lack of humility, etc. Okay? The second way is through using the tools that have been brought to us through the wisdom of Master Sha. In all of his books, he has 21 books now, there is wisdom, teachings, and practices. In about 15 of those 21 books, there are what's called divine downloads that are placed into those books, in which when you read them, you receive those and you can use those to facilitate much faster blessings. There's also tv.drshaw.com and other sources in which you can go to those sources and say, I would like some blessings, please, for this particular condition, lack of humility, problems with self-love, whatever it might be. These are self-help methods. There is also a third method, which is called special services. And this is one of the reasons why I'm sharing with this with you today, so that you're aware of these special services. It's always optional. But in essence, Dr. Master Sha, being one of the most renowned healers on the planet today, has been able to transmit abilities to bring huge shift in your life. To bring a balance, to maintain and sustain the highest optimum health and well-being in the physical, emotional, mental, and spiritual areas of your life. In stating this, I can share with you that these special services have the ability to transform lifetimes of blockages. And so if you really find yourself in a place of a lack of self-worth, you really need that boost to get out of that hole. You really need that boost to have a better perspective and realign your thinking, release some of the negative mindsets, attitudes, beliefs, the ego, of course, or attachments, then you want to contact me for those special services. So let's do a practice together. So everybody, wherever you're at, sit up straight. If you can, bring your back away from the back of the chair. This will allow for the frequency to flow through us as best as possible. I'm going to connect to the soul of the calligraphy and the countless blessings that have been infused into the calligraphy. I will ask it a service. We'll also chant the mantra of Da Chen Bei. That is called sound power. Body power, I'm going to ask you to place your hands back into the soul light arrow hand position, left hand in front of the heart center. Right hand gently reminded pointed towards heaven. And as you place your palms there, just relax. Don't worry about pushing your palm against your chest. You want to leave a little space there. Let the energy flow. Close your eyes. And we're going to invite in those that can serve us. Please repeat after me. Dear all the beings of light serving the plan of the light side, especially those that have come here today, I deeply appreciate you. I'm very grateful for your service, and I thank you for any time you have served me in all time. I ask that you please come to sit in my heart center. Please bless me to release blockages associated with my lack of self-esteem. Please bless me to release blockages that are inhibiting me from honoring and loving myself. Please bless me to see and more easily align to the incredible love and beauty that my Creator has surrounded me with. Please bless me to fulfill my heart with the Creator's love so that I can move forward and be a fully inclusive, self-loving person that has the greatest humility and the least amount of ego. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And now we'll do a forgiveness. So again, if comfortable, please repeat after me. Dear my soul, dear all souls, if I have communicated with you in such a way that has caused you to have a condition of low self-esteem. I sincerely, sincerely apologize if I have ever been emotionally or mentally abusive towards you, physically abusive towards you, in any time. Truly, I deeply apologize. Dear my own soul, dear my heavens team, I love you. I thank you. Could you please bless me today to self-clear my blockages for loving myself? Bless me to release ego and to have more humility. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. And so, as we chant Da Qian Bei, which is the sound power, visualize in your heart center the greatest love coming from your creator. Visualize yourself forgiving yourself, loving yourself. If there are individuals that you know you had great unpleasant expression towards, you would wished you had been more humble, wished you had had less ego, then in your mind's eye, in your heart center, ask for forgiveness. Let us chant together Da Qian Bei. Give me a moment to invoke the calligraphy. Dear the soul of the Da Qian Bei calligraphies, all of them that Master Sha has created, including the ones in the Soul Healing Miracles book, I love you, honor you, appreciate you. Could you please come out at this time? Please offer your blessings as appropriate to all those watching this video. As we chant Da Qian Bei, please bless us for our request. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Let us begin. Da Qian Bei, 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 greatest humility, greatest humility, greatest humility, greatest humility. Da Qian Bei, Da Qian Bei, Da Qian Bei, Da Qian Bei, greatest humility, greatest humility, greatest humility, greatest humility, Da Qian Bei, Da Qian Bei, Da Qian Bei, Da Qian Bei. Now, silently, I want you to chant silently. I'm going to walk you through a beautiful meditation. I want you to see yourself inside your heart center. You're a golden, bright soul standing inside your own heart center. You're very, very bright. And as you look around your heart center, you see these, they're like cracks, cracks in your heart center. And the love is leaking out these cracks. These cracks were formed by separation from the source. They were formed by ego. They were formed by judgments and criticisms of yourself and of others. As you stand in your heart center, in your own golden light body, see these cracks above you, wherever they're at. Maybe they're below you, maybe they're to your right or your left. Some may be large, some may be very small. But just notice them all. Now I want you to ask your beloved Creator to shine their light on you. And I want you to see that light coming in through the top of your head. It's coming into the heart center of you in your golden being as you are inside your heart center. Visualize this incredible divine love. Feel the divine's love coming through the top of your crown into your golden light body as you stand in your heart center. Visualize very clearly this incredible love. Feel the divine's love. He loves you. Feel the divine's love for you. Remember the original love that has always been there for you. Remember the original healing. Remember the original purity. Feel it coming in, filling up your golden light body. Your golden light body that is standing inside your heart center is getting bigger and brighter, and it radiates out in these shards of light that go directly to the cracks and crevices of your heart center that you observed. And as this golden light goes to these cracks and crevices, it starts healing those areas of your message center, your heart center, almost like a laser beam, purifying, cleansing, smoothing over the wound of the past, of the times that you had allowed wrong information to come in, of the times you had accepted that you were less than. And it, as this light that comes through your crown chakra into your heart center expands out to these cracks and crevices, see them now fully, fully healing. See the cracks and crevices fully, fully smoothing over with the greatest love. Shine your greatest light to the entire heart center that you're in right now until you can barely see your own golden body anymore. Shine that light. Da Chen Bei, Da Chen Bei. Da Chen Bei, Da Chen Bei, Da Chen Bei, greatest humility releases ego. Da Chen Bei, greatest humility, Da Chen Bei, greatest humility, releases ego, boost my self-esteem, heals my message center, releases self-judgment, release self-criticism, heals my heart center, heals my heart center, heals my heart center, heals my heart center. See the light. You can barely see yourself. You're so golden right now. The purity of the divine's love cannot be measured. It continues to flow in with such extraordinary amounts that it is now in your entire physical vessel. There is not one part of your entire physical body that is not being bathed in the Divine's love. Feel the Divine's love. Feel it in every cell. I love you. I love you. You have always been perfect. You have always been accepted. And as I chant one round of love, peace, and harmony, offer your gratitude to the Divine, your Creator. Offer your gratitude for the love that has brought healing to this area. I love my heart and soul. I love all humanity. Join hearts and souls together. Love, peace, and harmony. Love, peace, and harmony. How. Thank you, thank you, thank you. So please gently return from this blessed meditation. And please share what, if any, that you might have experienced. Did you go into a deep meditative place and receive any images? Did you receive any messages from the soul world? Are you feeling different than when you started? And if so, in what way? Did you feel any movement in your heart center? Any pains? Sometimes people feel pains in their heart center. I felt my crown chakra light up quite a bit, and I heated up probably 30 degrees. Literally, before I do these live streams, I have to put on underarm deodorant. Before and after, not a problem. During the live streams, sweating profusely. There's so much frequency coming through to bring blessings to you all. So I look forward to your sharing. So the subject of humility in relationship to love of ourself is not a natural one. It's not of one that people would consider so much because we don't think of it in that way. But you know, in conclusion, very often what we want to pay attention to is how are we separating ourselves from the Divine? And if we're not loving ourselves, guess what? We're separating ourselves from our Creator. So it's very, very important to do whatever we can to realign ourselves, including paying attention to when we deny ourselves, when we disallow that positive comment to ourselves, when we hide behind a falsity that we call protection, when we could be making a choice that is actually better for us. So these are some examples. So I'm going to read some of the comments now. And Dean Willis says, thank you, Master Paul. You're very welcome, Dean. Susan says, I feel lighter, more aware, and see some things I have been wondering about. Clarity was brought. Namaste. You're very welcome, Susan. Great to see you joining us here today. Stephanie, thank you, Master Paul, for bringing more light to her heart and soul, feeling more peaceful. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Love you, love you, love you. You're very welcome. Aloha, Kristen. Thank you for your response. And Don Brown says, wow, heat is right. I saw many beings coming towards me and we all embraced. Wonderful, beautiful sharing. Carol Whitney says, crown chakra amplified with a fuzzy energy. And she feels that's what it felt like. And she feels light, that's what it felt like. And CJ says, wow, what a wonderful wisdom. Tearful, so grateful for this practice. I see a soul humbly kneeling in a bright light. Can't help myself from tears. Thank you, God, and bless Master Paul. Thank you, God. Thank you, Creator. So this was, thank you, Dana. This was some sacred wisdoms from the base teachings of one of the 10 Das known as the greatest humility. So I encourage you to return tomorrow, because there's a lot of ways in which we have brought ego and responses that we would not be proud of into one or more relationships. And tomorrow we're going to be focusing on humility in relationship, both to clear blockages from the past and to create a far better one if we're currently in one now. Okay, so I look forward to that as well tomorrow. If you found yourself having some blockages with this subject matter and you feel you could benefit from some special services to help you clear these blockages, then I would recommend what's called a crown chakra blessing. And that blessing is extraordinary. I'm happy to give you more information on that. You can contact me again through Facebook Messenger, and that would help you significantly to clear those blockages and move much more rapidly towards alignment with the divine. So thank you all for hitting the share button. Thank you all for coming. For those that came in late, I encourage you to watch this again right after we're done here. For all those that are new that have enjoyed this, please hit the subscribe button that will show up upon posting right after this, about 1 or 2 minutes. And until then, I will see you tomorrow. Love you, love you, love you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Gong song, gong song, gong song. Bye-bye, everybody.